Okay. It's a little more challenging here because this one here, again, now this time around, oh, I got to delete this because I need to take this off so that I can zoom in here and there. With this lesson right here, okay, I cannot stress enough. Now, with this lesson here, it changes things when now there's a number next to the x squared, okay? Let's skip this. Let's focus on this. What is the factored form of this? Well, notice how there's x's in all of them, but I can take out two things. I can divide them all by three, all the terms, and I can also take out an x. So notice what it looks like now. Boop, 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 boop. Then I can factor this using the magic x. Boop. So there you go. 3x times x minus 1, x plus 6. You need to understand what to factor first, okay? So now let's do this on a separate sheet of paper, okay? 5x squared, let's go back to this, minus 35x plus 50. Okay, so minus 35x and then plus 50. I can divide these all by 5. I can't take anything else, okay? Or take out anything else. So I'm left with x squared minus 7x plus 10. Okay, when we do the magic x, two numbers multiplied at 10, add to negative 7, it's negative 5, negative 2. So I'm left with 5 on the outside, x minus 5, x minus 2, boop, we did it. Okay, not difficult there. Understand how to do the magic x. Let's do this one here. Okay, in fact, we'll even do it on here. I can divide everything here by 6, actually not, yeah, by 6. But I can also take out 1x, so let's do that. Okay, so if I take out 6x, I've got x squared plus 5x plus 4. When I do the magic x, here's 4 on the top, 5 on the bottom. It's going to be 4 and 1, so we did it. 6x, x plus 4, x plus 1, boop, we got it. Okay, it's going to change things a little bit when we can't take anything out, and there's going to be a number next to the x squared, okay? What I like to do is use the magic X, okay? So let's ignore part A. Let's focus now on part B, okay? Let's focus on this, okay? This right here. We now need to identify A, B, and C. And what we're gonna do instead is AC is on the top, B is on the bottom, AC is multiplication, B is addition, okay? So notice this. In this example right here, we're now considering two numbers that multiply to 6 times 4. So 24 is going to go on the top, and on the bottom, it's going to be 11, okay? And that's going to be 8 and 3. Notice how now we have to expand the middle to then group up two terms at a time. Follow along, because I'm going to do this one right here, and I'm actually going to do it on here, as a matter of fact. So we can do the magic X pretty easily. 30 on the top, 17 on the bottom. Well, that's going to be 15 and 2, okay? We use those to change the middle. 10x squared plus 15x plus 2x plus 3. And then my next step, as you see over here, boop, 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 we group up two terms at a time to see what we can take out. Here, I can take out a 5 and an x. So I'm left with 2x plus 3. And the other one, I can't take anything out. But I can take out a 1, essentially. I got 2x plus 3, okay? I know I'm correct if these are the same, okay? So the first factor is 2x plus 3. The second factor is 5x plus 1. Whatever I took out, boop, I put those together, okay? Let's do one more example for the sake of argument here, okay? When we magic x this, we're going to multiply the 2 and negative 21, negative 42. On the bottom, it's positive 1. If there's no number here, we assume it's a 1, okay? In this case, it's going to be 6 and 7, and the 6 is going to be negative. So now let's expand the middle here. 2x squared minus 6x plus 7x minus 21, and I group up two terms at a time. Here, I can take out a 2 and an x. I'm left with x minus 3, okay? I can take out a 7 from the other one, x minus 3. I know I'm correct because those are the same. So it's going to be x minus 3. And then 2x plus 7, put those together. Boom, we did it. Okay? One more page, as we have one more example. Okay, definitely absorb this because this is crucial. Okay? How can we substitute to help you factor? Well, it's the same idea. Okay? So, I think it's pretty much the same thing, essentially. Okay? So, We're actually going to skip substitution. You can ignore this. If you can do the magic X, it's doable. So let's actually do one more. This, okay? Negative 10 on the top, 3 on the bottom. Well, that's 5 and 2, and the 2 is negative. So let's expand. 10x squared plus 5x minus 2x minus 1. Group up 2 at a time. Here I can take out a 5 and an x, so I'm left with 2x plus 1. I can't take anything out from here, so I'm going to put a minus 1, since there's a minus on the outside. That will change to a positive. Okay, no, I'm correct because these are the same. 2x plus 1, and then 5x minus 1. Boop, we did it. Okay, that's actually going to cover the lesson for today, guys, or for this lesson. Okay, one more to go. Definitely read this. The grouping one will be very important. 7-7 coming at you.